Namaste. Welcome back. And today again we are continuing our journey of the great saint of India, Neem Karoli Baba. And today I'm going to share with you people another story, a beautiful story, how Neem Karoli Baba got his name, Neem Karoli, and how it all started. So this story goes back when Ramdas tells us that the Baba Lakshman Das, his original name was Lakshman Das Sharma, and no one knows exactly his original name, but he was born around 1900. This is a rough story that he was born around 1900, and then in 1958 Baba Lakshman Das, or Neem Karoli Baba as we know today, boarded a train without a ticket, and the conductor decided to halt the train. And he forced Neem Karoli Baba off the train, and he pushed him and he forced him out of the train. And at the village of Neem Karoli, the village of the at the which the train was standing was called Neem Karoli. It is in Farukhabad district, actually, basically Uttar Pradesh is a state in India. So after boarding Baba off the train, the conductor, he found that the train would not start again. So he tried a lot. He was trying a lot that maybe the train should start, and why isn't it is not starting. But after doing several attempts, and he was trying a lot harder, that yes, it should start, but it was not starting actually. So after several attempts at starting the train, someone suggested to the conductor that they allow the sadhu back on the train. So Neem Karoli agreed to board the train on two conditions: that the railway company promises to build a station for the village of the Neem Karoli, because at that point of time there was no station, and people had to, that was just a raw platform basically on which the people had to stand and keep waiting, and second, that the railway company should treat sadhus better and in a better way. And the officials agreed at that point of time. And Neem Karoli Baba, when he boarded the train, he said jokingly, he said, "What is it up to me that the train starts?" Immediately after boarding the train, the train started actually. So that was the, that was a very amazing thing which had happened, that when he was, disrespected, he was thrown out of the train. The train was not starting. But after, he was requested and he boarded the train again, the train started. That was a part of his leela. A leela, to encourage the company officials, or at that point of time, the Britishers were still there in India, when India had gained independence, and India was a freshly, independent country, and Britishers were still there. But they never respected the sadhus at that point of time. They didn't respect them too well. So Neem Karoli Baba just wanted that to teach them somehow a valuable lesson, that what can a sadhu do. And Neem Karoli Baba actually, what I know from my perspective, is that he used to even control the basic aspects of nature. So that was the most important thing. And about his name, so he lived in the village of Neem Karoli for a while in the initial days. So as we come to know, it started to call Neem Karoli. He was given the name of Neem Karoli Baba. So thereafter he wandered extensively throughout northern India, and then he was known under different names by Lakshman Das, Baba Lakshman Das, Handi Wala Baba, Tikoniya Wala Baba, and Talaiya Baba. He was known Talaiya Baba in Gujarat. Local called him Chamatkari Baba also. And during his life, there were two main ashrams which were built. One is at Kanchi, it is near Bhowali in Uttarakhand, near Naital district. And the second is in Vrindavan, where he took the last breath. And over his name, a lot of 100 temples, have been constructed. So that is the thing, because Baba always wanted that sadhu should be, treated better. And in today's world also, we see that some people who are the fake sadhus, who are the fake babas, they are diminishing the values of Sanatan Dharma or Hinduism. And at that point of time, because the sadhus, the actual sadhus, the real sadhus, who who did penance for the for making the world a better place to live in. So that all is what he wanted, that people should treat sadhus better and in a better way, so that they work towards creating a society and they can impart their wisdom with us, because that's very important. So this is what I want to say, and I just want to say that before I finish up this story today, I just want to say that whenever you are alone, you are having problems in life, just close your eyes, just sit with the image of Neem Karoli Baba, just close your eyes and just pray to him. Just pray to him and all your prayers will be answered, my dear friend. There will be problems in life, there will be, you know, tensions in life, there will be a lot of things. But whenever you pray to him wholeheartedly, there will be solutions. There will be solutions, and there will be solutions big time. So I need to say to you that have faith and just impart good knowledge to the people, do good karma, good work for the people, expect nothing in return, and be a good human being. Thank you. And now if you like my channel, please subscribe and support my views, and together we can share stories and, you know, what happened with Neem Karoli Baba, what was the thing, what were his teachings, we can share among us, and we can make this world a better place to live in. Thank you. Namaste.